Hello everyone, now we are going to start with the second chapter of standard 7, that is fraction and decimals. In this video we are going to learn everything about fractions only. So let's start. Suppose if I have a pizza, okay, so this is my one pizza. If I divide my one pizza in 4 equal parts, it will look somewhat like this. Then if suppose I consider only one part of it, then it will look somewhat like this. Now, in order to represent this part in a numerical form, we will call this part as 1 of 4 of these parts. That is, this part is basically 1 by 4. These 4 are the total parts and this 1 is the part which we have considered. So, this part is 1 by 4. Now, if we consider 2 parts of all these 4, then we can represent this part in a numerical form as 2 by 4. And over here, we can represent these 3 parts as 3 by 4. Now, if you look here carefully, these 2 parts are basically half of the pizza, right? So, 2 upon 4 is basically half, that is 1 upon 2, because 2 ones are 2 and 2 therefore, we can cancel all these things. So the meaning of 2 upon 4 and 1 upon 2 is the same. Now, this 1 upon 4, 2 upon 4, 3 upon 4 are called as fractions. So all these numbers which has a numerator as its part and a denominator as its part are called as fraction. The number which is present on top of this line is numerator and the number which present below this line is called as denominator. This is numerator and this one is denominator. And such type of numbers are called as fractions. Now let's learn 3 types of fractions. First one is proper fraction. In proper fractions, whenever the numerator is less than the denominator, we can say the given fraction is a proper fraction. For example, 1 upon 4, 3 upon 6 and 2 upon 3 are proper fraction because in all cases, numerator is less than their denominators. 3 is less than 6, 2 is less than 3 and here 1 is less than 4. Now, the second is improper fraction. Whenever the numerator is greater than the denominator, for such fractions we call it as improper fraction. Example, 3 upon 2, 5 upon 3, 8 upon 6. So in the examples like wherever the numerator is greater than the denominator, we call such fraction as a improper fraction. Now let's try to understand mixed fraction, that is third type of fraction, mixed fraction. Suppose if I have 2 cookies and if I am eating 1 and half cookie, suppose this is my cookies which I have eaten only 1 and half of the cookies. So this is complete 1 cookie and this is part of another cookie, that is half, right? So mixed fraction is basically a whole and its part. So this 1 and half is an example of mixed fraction. So every mixed fraction has whole and part. For such examples, we call it as mixed fraction. Finding equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction is writing the given fraction using some different numbers but without changing their meaning. Now, say suppose if I take a number, my fraction as 1 upon 2. As we have discussed earlier, over here there was pizza of which we have considered only 2 parts of all 4 parts. So that pizza was 2 upon 4, that is 2 parts of 4, which is basically half pizza, right? And half we write it as 1 upon 2. So 2 upon 4 is or equivalent fraction to 1 upon 2. So similar kind of things we are going to do here only. Now, I want to write equivalent fractions of this 1 upon 2. So in order to find the equivalent fractions of 1 upon 2, first I will write this number as it is, and now I'm going to multiply the numerator and denominator with one same number, that is, say suppose 2 upon 2. So when I multiply 1 into 2, I will get answer as 2, and 2 into 2, I will get it as 4. So 2 upon 4 is basically 1 upon 2 only. So 2 upon 4 is equivalent fraction to 1 upon 2. Let's find one more. If I multiply now with next number, that is 3 upon 3, this number of a numerator and denominator has to be same. Now 1 into 3 is 3 and 2 into 3 is 6. Now we all know that 3 and 6 can be cancelled out as 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, which is again 1 upon 2. So the overall meaning is not changing, but we can represent this 1 upon 2 using some other numbers. So that number is called as equivalent fractions. We can find as many as we want. So suppose if I multiply this number with 4 upon 4, so this will be 1 into 4 is 4 and 2 into 4 is. So these are our equivalent fraction numbers of 1 upon 2. Find equivalent fraction of 2 upon 3 in the denominator 6. So 2 upon 3, we have to find the equivalent fraction with denominator 6. So basically here we have to find the numerator. So I write 2 upon 3 as it is, and in place of numerator, I will take it as x upon 6. So basically now we are going to find the value of x. So how do we find the value of x? We keep our x there itself. So I write 2 upon 3 here. I'll keep my x over here only. Now I will take this 6 to the other side of the infinity. Since this is divided, when it comes to the other side, it gets multiplied to the numerator. So denominator goes into numerator and gets multiplied. Now 2 into 6 is 12 upon 3, and this x as it is. 3 ones are 3, 3 fours are 12. Now 4 upon 1 is basically 4, therefore value of x is 4. So this is our numerator. So this is how we find the equivalent fraction with given any denominator or numerator. Fractions are again classified into two groups, that is like fraction and unlike fraction. So let's try to understand what are like fractions first. Like fractions are those which has same denominator. Example, 1 upon 3, 4 upon 3, 7 upon 3, 14 upon 3 and 17 upon 3. So in all these cases, we can see that denominator is same. That is 3 for this numerator, 3 for this numerator and so on. So in all the cases, denominator is the same. So therefore, all these numbers are called as like fractions. Now, in this case, you can see there's 2 upon 9. We have denominator in this case as 9 again, but with the different numerator, that is 16. So all these are again examples of like fractions. Now, let's try to understand unlike fractions. Unlike fractions are those which has different denominator. Example, 2 upon 3, 4 upon 6, 2 upon 9, 10 upon 13. So in all these cases, you can see that denominators are different. Therefore, these are classified into unlike fractions. Now let's try to understand how to compare the like fractions and unlike fractions. Which one is greater between 4 upon 3 and 7 upon 3? As you can see here, both these numbers are like fractions. And it is very easy to compare the like fractions because they have the same denominator. And whenever we have same denominator, we directly compare the numerator. And over here, we all know that 4 is less than 7. Therefore, we can directly write as 4 upon 3 will be less than 7 upon 3. So 7 upon 3 is greater than 4 upon 3. Now, if we try to understand it on number line, so this point, if I take as 0, so I will write it as 0 upon 3, which is basically 0 only. Now, this as 1 upon 3, 2 upon 3, 3 upon 3, which is basically 1, then 4 upon 3, 5 upon 3, 6 upon 3, which is basically 2, then 7 upon 3. As you can see here, 4 upon 3 lies over here towards the left hand side of 7 upon 3. And we all know that the number which lies towards the left is always less than the number lies towards the right. So we can say that 4 upon 3 is less than 7 upon 3. Now let's try to compare the unlike fractions. Compare 2 upon 3 and 3 upon 4. As you can see here, both these numbers are unlike fractions. Now, our first step is to make the denominator same. And how do we make the denominator same? That is by LCM. Finding the LCM of 3 and 4. 3 and 4. Finding the LCM of 3 and 4. So when I divide with 2, we all know that we cannot divide 3 by 2. So I'll write 3 as it is. Now, if I divide this 4 with 2, I will get 2. Now again, 2, we cannot divide 3, so I'll write 3 over here as it is. But we can divide 2, that is 2 ones are 2. Now, 3, so we will take 3, and 3 it can be divided by 3. So 3 ones are 3 and 3. So our prime factorization is 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3. So our LCM is now 12. So this is our LCM. So now, in order to make this 3 12, we'll have to multiply it with 4. Since we are multiplying it with 4, we are multiplying the numerator as well as with 4. So 2 4s are 8 and 3 4s are 12. So this is the equivalent fraction of 2 upon 3, which is basically the same. Now 3 upon 4. So LCM was 12, right? So we all know that 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, 4 3s are 12. Now as you can see here, 8 upon 12 and 9 upon 12. Now we are getting two like fractions. So let's compare these two like fractions, that is 8 upon 12, we all know that it is less than 9 upon 12. Since these are like fractions, we directly compare the numerator and we all know that 8 is less than 9. Therefore, 2 upon 3 is less than 3 upon 4, which is 9 upon 12. So this is how we compare the unlike fractions. Let's learn the addition and subtraction of fractions. First problem, 3 upon 4 plus 5 upon 4. As you can see here, these both are like fractions. And addition of like fraction is very much easy. That is, we keep denominators same and directly add the numerators in like fractions. So 3 plus 5 is 8 upon this 4. We all know that 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So our final answer is 2. But in unlike fractions, the addition is little bit different. We cannot add directly numerator to numerator because the denominators are not same. So first thing is we need to make them same. But in order to make them same, we'll have to find the LCM and then we'll have to find the fractions and then we have to add, right? So but in this case, we are not going to find the LCM, but we are going to directly find the answer. That is by multiplying 6 to this 2, then this 2 to this 3 and 6 with this 4 and then adding their answers. That is 3 will be multiplied with 2, then plus 6 will be multiplied to 4 upon 6 will be again multiplied to 2. Now 3 2s are 6 plus 4 6s are 24 upon 6 to the 12. 6 plus 24 is 30 upon 12. We can again further reduce this number, that is 2 6 is 12 and 2 15 is 30. So our final answer is 15 upon 6. So this is how we solve the unlike fractions, addition of unlike fractions. Now let's look here. Subtraction of 4 upon 3 and 2 upon 3. Again, these two numbers are like fractions, and like fraction, subtraction of like fraction is also same as addition of like fraction. That is, we will be directly subtracting the numerators. So 4 minus 2, keeping the denominator same. 4 minus 2 is 2 upon 3. So this is our final answer. In this case, over here you can see that we have unlike fractions. That is, the denominators are different. So now we are going to follow this method. That is, now over here in this case also we are going to multiply 2 with 5, then 5 with 1 and 2 with 1. That is, 1 will be multiplied to 5, subtracted by 2 will be multiplied to 1 upon 2 multiplied by 5. Now 1 multiplied by 5 is 5, subtracted by 1 multiplied by 2 is 2. 2 multiplied by 5 is 10. 5 minus 2 is 3 upon 10. So this is our final answer. Now let's learn the multiplication and division of fractions. First problem, 3 upon 4 multiplied by 5 upon 4. Both are like fractions. And in this case, 3 upon 6 multiplied by 4 upon 2. These are unlike fractions. But in multiplication, we need not care about what are the like fractions or whether they are unlike fractions, because we can directly multiply numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator, we will get our answer. So that is, if I multiply 3 with 5 and 4 with 4, I will get my answer. 3 5 is 15 and 4 4 is 16. So this is my final answer. So in this case also, if I multiply numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator, I will get my answer. 3 4 is 12 and 6 2 is 12, which is basically 1. There is one more method to solve this multiplication. That is, in multiplication, we are allowed for the cross cancellation. Here you can see that we all know that 2 2s are 4 and 2 3s are 6. So I can solve this problem as 2 2s are 4 and 2 3s are 6. Now if I multiply 3 to 2 and again here 3 with this 2, I will get my answer as 6 upon 6, which is basically 1. So whichever method you find it easy, you can solve it in your convenient method. Over here, division. 4 upon 3 is divided by 2 upon 3, and we all know that division is inverse multiplication. So 4 upon 3, we can write it as multiplied to 3 upon 2, because division is inverse multiplication. Here you can see that 3 and 3 can get cancelled off, and 4 multiplied by 1 is 4, and 1 over here, 1 multiplied by 2 is 2, so which is basically 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, so our final answer is 2. Over here, 1 upon 2 divided by 1 upon 5. 1 upon 2, we can write it as an inverse multiplication, multiplied by 5 upon 1. Since we cannot cancel 5 and 2, we can directly multiply numerator to numerator, that is 1 into 5 is 5 and 2 into 1 is 2. So this is our final answer. So in multiplication and division, we did not care what are the like fractions and what are the unlike fractions. In multiplication, we can multiply numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator directly, and we can get our answer. And in division, we change the division into multiplication, that is inverse. We are finding the reciprocal of 2 upon 3. Reciprocal means writing the numbers upside down. So reciprocal of 2 upon 3 is 3 upon 2. So this 3 upon 2 is called as reciprocal of 2 upon 3. Say suppose if I have a number 1 upon 2 and we have to find the reciprocal of 1 upon 2, so that will be 2 upon 1, which is basically 2. So reciprocal of 1 upon 2 is 2. So reciprocal is basically writing the inverse of a given number. Now let's learn to convert improper fraction to a mixed fraction. We have an improper fraction that is 18 upon 7 and we have to write this improper fraction as a mixed fraction. And we all know that mixed fraction has a whole part and its part. So our whole will be quotient and our part will be remainder upon divisor, which we are going to find after dividing this 18 by 7. So let's do that. 18 by 7. Now 7 2's are 14 and 18 minus 14 is 4. Now in place of quotient we have 2, so I write 2 as my whole and the part will be remainder upon divisor, so that is 4 is my remainder and this 7 over here is divisor. As you can see, I have a whole and my part, so this is a mixed fraction of 18 upon 7. Now if I want to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction, I will be using a formula, that is quotient multiplied by divisor plus remainder upon divisor. Now here we all know that this is basically quotient and remainder upon divisor. Yes, so if you multiply quotient to divisor plus remainder, we will get our numerator. So quotient multiplied by divisor, that is 3 multiplied by 7 plus this 4 as our remainder upon this divisor as 7. We all know that 3 sevens are 21 plus 4 upon 7. 21 plus 4 is 25 and 7. So this is our improper fraction. So as you can see, we have converted our mixed fraction to an improper fraction by using this formula over here. We have to just identify this mixed fraction in terms of quotient remainder upon divisor, which is basically a whole and its part. So this is how we convert mixed fraction to an improper fraction and improper fraction to a mixed fraction.